Hello everyone, and welcome back to another Tooltip Tuesday. Today's Tooltip Tuesday is going to be on a bit more discussion on the timeline panel. So here I've got a Ripper Form Relief three fluted milling cutter, and let's go ahead and understand how the timeline function helps us with simulation and all the other manipulative tasks. So at the bottom of my screen here, you can see the timeline panel, and you are able to hide them by just clicking right click on it and deselect it, and the timeline panel goes away. And if you want to bring it back, you just need to go to the left vertical section and again right click and click on the timeline panel, and the timeline panel appears back again. Also, one more thing to note is it could also be a floating window. The timeline panel can be independently moved out, so you can either use the selection here or just double click, and you will see that the timeline panel is now floating. And if you have a second screen you're working on, it can be moved out as well. Or if you have a single screen, you can actually dock it back into this particular screen and station. You may also notice here that there's an arrow next to the max, which I'll probably go in a bit more deeper later on, which is the animation speed. At the moment, the only selection is, or the default selection is, the animation speed. What we could do is we could expand it by right clicking, and there are many other options available. So let's go ahead and select every one of them. So all the options available in the timeline panel are now selected, and you can see from top to bottom. So the first one is the collision. So that is where the in the timeline panel, that's where the collision is detected. So you can quickly move it there, and you could have a closer look at what's happening. And I'm just showing an example here of how collision can be detected, just to expose it. Moving out of that, you can also see that there are many other functions available here. So a feature on the cutting tool, so you could toggle them independently between features, or you could go to each operation if you like by using the step forward and step backward selection here. And also you can go to the different moves as well, along with the fluting number of flutes, and you can skip between the flutes as well as you go through each feature. Additionally, you can also see the feed rate being displayed. You can see the Q value, that's the material, the volume of material removed, or the material removal rate, which is expressed in millimeter cube per second, and also the Q prime max value, which is the expressed in millimeters per millimeter square per second, as it is the largest area of the wheel in contact for that particular operation or tool. So you can see here very clearly that the Q value, or the MRR value, for the OD finishing operation is quite flat, but you can actually see that there are areas of the wheel which are exposed to more material exposure on the wheel, which is the area, and that is expressed in millimeter square per second. Now, one other thing to note here is while holding the control key and using your mouse roller, you are able to zoom in and out or expand the timeline. And obviously, you can always go back and reset zoom if and when required. So that was an explanation on how the timeline feature can be exposed and what are the available parameters which can be exposed. Perhaps in the upcoming videos, we will discuss a little bit more in detail on some of these independent parameters and how we can use them. So again, thank you very much for watching this episode. We'll see you next time with another Tooltip Tuesday next week. Thank you for watching.